All of you first look at overview of the lesson. We are going to start the first lesson of political science, power sharing, and have a look at overview what we are going to learn in this lesson, or maybe in the next two lessons what we are going to learn. So look at the third line: an intelligent sharing of power among legislature, executive and judiciary is very important to design of a democracy. Already in class 9th we had studied the lesson of democracy, and if you remember we have studied the arguments in favor of democracy, arguments against democracy. So we know what are the good features of democracy. So in this first lesson and the second lesson of political science, we are going to learn how power is being shared, that is between your legislature, executive and judiciary. Any democracy, you will find these three levels, as that is legislature, executive and judiciary, they do share power. But the power sharing methods can be different countries. Okay, go to the next line. We carry this idea of power sharing forward. Now, power sharing idea which we studied here, legislature, executive, judiciary, how do they share the power? We start with two stories. Okay, the two stories are Belgium and Sri Lanka. So you are going to learn the two stories of two countries. Belgium is a European country, Sri Lanka is a Asian country. So we are going to learn the topic how the power is being shared among legislature, among executive and among judiciary, with the help of two countries example, that is of Sri Lanka and Belgium. So these two stories we are going to start here. Now let's move to the lesson. Now look at the lesson. Okay, now the lesson is given over here, Belgium and Sri Lanka. So we are starting the lesson with the help of two examples. We will learn the story of Belgium and we will learn the story of Sri Lanka. So first story which is given here is of Belgium. Okay, now look at the textbook. Belgium is a small country in Europe, smaller in area than the state of Haryana. Okay, now Belgium is a very small country in Europe. It is so small that our country, our state, Haryana is a small state. So even it is smaller than Haryana state. Okay, now let's see what are the borders of this country. It has border with France, Netherlands, Germany and Luxembourg. So you must know which countries are sharing the border with Belgium, because it makes a lot of difference, the countries which are having, the countries which are around our, the border of the country, they make a lot of difference in those countries. Okay, the first country is given here. France is the neighboring country of Belgium. Netherlands is the neighboring country. Germany is the neighboring country. Luxembourg. So four countries are given which are sharing the border with Belgium. So do remember. It has a population of a little over 1 crore, about half the population of Haryana. Look at here. It's not like that India is having huge second largest population of the world. But this country, which is smaller than Haryana, is even having half the population of Haryana. And it is, its population is around over 1 crore. So it is not a very large population like India. It is less population, but in that less population also they have some ethnic problems. Now what are those ethnic problems? Now go to the next line. You will get a term over here, ethnic. Before going to the next line, we need to understand the meaning of ethnic. The definition is given over here. Look at, first we will go to the definition. Look at the box, glossary you see of your textbook. Look at the glossary of your textbook. What is ethnic? We need to understand. A social division based on shared culture. People belonging to the same ethnic group believe in their common descent because of similarities of physical type or of culture or both. They need not to have the same religion and nationality. Now you need to understand, actually ethnic means a group of people. The group can be very large group, it's not that very small group. So those people or that community, they have the same physical features. The structure wise I'm talking about, the physical feature means their nose, hair, color, all these things. Even their culture is also same. So they form a ethnic group. People having the same culture, people having the same physical features, they form one ethnic group. Their language can be different, their nationality can be different. So ethnicity, you need to remember, a community or a big large group of people, those who are having the same physical type of structure, features and same culture, they form a ethnic group. Okay, now let's move to the lesson. Now look at the ethnic group. The ethnic composition of Belgium is very complex. Though the country is very small, Belgium is a small country and it is having only 1 crore population, over 1 crore population, but the ethnic composition of this country is complex. That means different communities are there in this country. Now which are the communities they live here? Look at here. The overall total population of the country's total population, okay, 59% live in the Flemish region and speak Dutch language. Okay, before going to this paragraph, we need to see the map. Look at the map, then you will understand. Look at this map. Now, first you look at the index which is given over here. Now, the first one, the little orange color, it is given Brussels. Brussels is the capital of Belgium. Okay, like how Delhi is the capital of India, same way Brussels is the capital of Belgium. Then one state is there, that state's name is Wallonia. Okay, Wallonia is red in color in the map it is given. This is your Wallonia. Then light yellow color or the greenish color, that is Flemish. Now look at here, in Wallonia, French is the main language. Okay, that means French people are more in that area. In Flemish, Dutch speaking people are more. And only 1% German is there. Those German occupy only a little place of the country. So this part is your German. Now look at the map very clearly. The first one is the yellow color is, this one is the Flemish area. This one is Wallonia. And this part is your where the German lives. And this is a small area which is occupied by the Brussels, the capital. Now, very clearly you can look at this map. Now here, two states are there. Like in India, there are so many states. But this country is a small in area and this country is having only two states. One is known by the name Flemish. Clear? Flemish. And the second one is known by the name Wallonia. In Flemish, there are, which community lives in the Flemish? Flemish Dutch people, they live in Dutch. Flemish. Very good. And in Wallonia, French speaking people live. So very clearly demarcation is there. One state is for the French people, one state is for the Dutch people, and there is a small area occupied by the Germans. Only 1%. So you have overall view, you got it, that Belgium is a small country, but they have three ethnic groups. The first is the French people, second is the Dutch people, third is the German. Now you have got the idea. Now let's move to the paragraph so that you will understand nicely. Now look at this small paragraph. Now, of the country's total population, 59% in the Flemish, they live in the Flemish region, speak Dutch language. So out of total population of the country, 59%, okay, that means large part of the country people speak Dutch, okay, and they live in Flemish. Now moving to the second ethnic group, that is about 40% people live in Wallonia region, speak French. So 59, they are Dutch, they live in Flemish, 40% they are French speaking people and they live in the Wallonia state. So please do remember there are two states. One is Flemish, one is Wallonia. In Flemish there are 59% people and they speak Dutch. Clear? And in Wallonia there are 40% people, they speak French. So 59 and 40, it became 99. Am I right? Now 1% is remaining. Remaining 1%, okay, they speak German. Okay, that's why in the beginning you got it, the neighboring countries. Look at the neighboring countries. There is France. So you got French people over there in Belgium. There is German in Germany. So German people also there in that country. Clear? So you have understood why the bordering countries are important to learn about that Belgium. So we got three ethnic composition. Now I repeat, please do listen nicely, that in Belgium we have three ethnic groups. The first one is Dutch, that is the largest. Okay, they are having 59% of the population, total population of the countries. Okay, out of total population. Now 40% people, they are French, and only 1% people is German. So Dutch, French, German, these are the three ethnic groups. Clear? Now this is the structure of the whole country, where we find Dutch people, where we find French people, where we find German people. Now we are taking Brussels. Now what is the situation in the Brussels? In the capital city of Brussels, 80% people speak French and only 20% people speak Dutch. Now see, the story is completely opposite in the Brussels. In the whole country, Dutch are in majority, 59%. And 40% is French, so compared to that, French are less. But always the capital cities are very important for any country. But in the capital city, it is not like that. In the capital city, which community is more in number? Tell me. Which community is there in?
French.
Very good. What is the percentage of French people over there? 80% is French and only 20% is Dutch. Okay, so you need to understand the whole composition of the country. 59 in Flemish, that is Dutch. 40% in Wallonia, that is French. Only 1% people, they speak German. These are the three ethnic groups. But when you go to the capital city of Brussels, it is exactly opposite. Their French are more. They are 80% of the population. So they are in majority. Clear? French are in majority, 80%. Now Dutch, they are less in number. They are only 20%. Okay. So you have understood this much. Now let's move to the next paragraph. The minority French speaking community was relatively rich and powerful. This was resented by the Dutch speaking community, who got the benefit of economic development and education much later. Now you have to understand this paragraph. Look at here. The minority French speaking community. Okay, out of the total population, only 40% are French, 59 are Dutch speaking. But this French group of people, they are comparatively rich. Rich means they have more money resources and they are more powerful. You know, money makes a person power, gives power. So this French people, they are relatively, comparatively from the Dutch people, they are rich. Not only money wise, even education wise, they are much ahead of the Dutch people. So this thing was not liked by the Dutch people. They did not like that French people are more educated, French people are more rich. So there was a cold war between these two communities, because Dutch, they were not liking that French, they are from the other country. They came from French and settled down over here. They are rich and they are more education wise, far ahead of them. Okay. So you need to remember why there was tension between the French and Dutch people. The main reason was the Dutch people did not like that French, they are rich and they are having more education. Okay, now moving to the next one. This led to tension between the Dutch speaking and French speaking communities during 1915 and 1960s. Now, this led to tension. Now, can anybody tell me what led to tension? What led to tension between these two communities, French and Dutch people, in the decade or during the year right from 1950s to 1960? That means 10 years there was...
The Dutch did not get an education.
Correct.
Education properly.
Yeah, they couldn't get the education early, even they were not having that much money resources. That's why Dutch people, they were not liking the French people. So there was tension between these two communities. There was Cold War between these two communities, that is between the year right from 1950s to 1960. That means 10 years this tension lasted. Okay. The tension between the two communities was more acute in Brussels. Now, look at here. The tension was more in Brussels. Why? Because in Brussels, French were dominating and Dutch, they were small in number. But in the country, Dutch were more and French were less. Dutch 59 and French 40%. But in the Brussels, French 80% and Dutch 20%. So this was the difference between these two communities, maybe majority, minority, and this tension was more acute in the capital city. I hope you have understood. Now moving to the next line. Brussels presented a special problem. The Dutch-speaking people constituted a majority in the country, but they are minority in the capital. So you need to keep in mind, the Dutch people, though they were majority in the country, throughout the country, but in the capital city, their number was less. So this problem was more acute in the capital city. The tension was more there. Okay. So tell me, did you understand the... Let us compare this to the situation in another country. That is Sri Lanka we are going to learn. Sri Lanka is an island nation just a few kilometers off the southern coast of Tamil Nadu. So it is our neighboring country, a small country to the south of India, and it's quite near to Tamil Nadu. It has about 2 crore people. Now look at here. Now it is given that Sri Lanka's population is almost similar to the population of Haryana. Like other nations in the South Asia region, Sri Lanka has a diverse population. Diverse means different ethnic groups, like Belgium, even like our own country, India. You can see so many type of people are here, so many language people are here, so many religion people are here. So we have a diverse population. Same way Sri Lanka is also having a diverse population. Okay. Now let us see the ethnic composition of Sri Lanka. Now what is the ethnic composition of Sri Lanka? The major social groups are the Sinhala speakers. Now the local language of Sri Lanka is a Sinhala. Okay, so Sinhala speaker, the people, those who speak Sinhala language, they are 74% out of the total population. They are 74%. The next important group is Tamil speakers. As the Tamil Nadu is the nearest state, so many Tamil people, they migrated in the olden times. Okay, you know the story of your Ramayana, that Sita was in Sri Lanka and Rama went from India, and there was a Setu. Setu means there was a bridge between India and Sri Lanka. There the bridge was made by Vanar Sena, by placing their big rocks, and they cross the ocean and they reach to Sri Lanka. So the Tamils are there right from that time in Sri Lanka, and they form 18%. Now see the difference, 74% and 18%. Now look at Belgium. Belgium 59-40. The difference was not very huge difference. 59% Dutch and 40 was French. Okay, but now look at the case of Sri Lanka. It is very vast difference. 74 is Sinhala people and 18% is Tamil speaker. Now this Tamil is again divided. Among Tamils there are two subgroups. Now look at here. Tamils are 18%, but this Tamil is again divided into two subgroups. That means they are again further divided into two types. Now what are those two types? Tamil natives of the country. Originally they belong from Sri Lanka. So Tamil natives of the country. So Tamil natives are known by which name? They are known by the name Sri Lankan Tamils. Clear? The Tamils are divided into two groups. One is known by the name Tamil, Sri Lankan Tamils. The other one is known as Indian Tamils. So did you understand the difference? One is Sri Lankan Tamil, one is Indian Tamils. Sri Lankan Tamils are the native of Sri Lanka and they are having only 13% of the population, and out of 18, 13 are Sri Lankan Tamils, the rest 5% whose forefathers came from India as plantation workers during the colonial period. Now during the British time, you know that British people ruled over India for 200 years. Now during the British time, the British people took the Indians from India, and because they were also ruling over Sri Lanka, so they took some Indians, that too from the Tamil Nadu, and they were taken to the plantation. Which plantation? Tea plantation. So many Indians migrated during the colonial period. Colonial period means the British period, to Sri Lanka, and they were working in the tea plantations, and these people are known by the name Indian Tamils. I hope you have understood now who are Indian Tamils and who are Sri Lankan Tamils. Now Sri Lankan Tamils are the native people of Sri Lanka. Indian Tamils, they migrated from India and they settled down in Sri Lanka. And now remember, Tamil speaking people are 18%. Out of the 18%, 13% are the Sri Lankan Tamils and only 5% are the Indian Tamils. I hope you have understood. We'll move to the map afterwards. Now let me complete this paragraph. Tamils are concentrated in the north and east of the country. Most of the Sinhala speaking people are Buddhist, while most of the Tamils are Hindus or Muslims. There are about 7% they are Christians, okay? And they speak Tamil or Sinhala. Now look at here, need to understand this. We know 74% Sinhala and 18% Tamils. Out of 18, 13% Sri Lankan Tamil, 5% Indian Tamil. Now all the Sri Lankans, those who speak, most of the Sri Lankans, those who speak Sinhala, they follow Buddhism. Okay, so they follow Buddhism. And the Tamil speaking people, those who are there, some are Hindus and some are Muslims. Okay, now 7% people, they are Christians over there. But you see the difference, again this Christian people, some speak Tamil, some speak Sinhala. So such a complex ethnic composition is there in Sri Lanka.